since you've been here, you got married to our pal Jack Antonoff.
I did.
Come on.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
I know.
Was it everything you dreamt of? Was it so fun?
Yes.
It was. It was, right?
Yeah, it was the best day of my life. It was amazing. It was so fun. It was...
He's such a good guy.
I know.
You're such a good person. I mean, you guys together, just absolutely perfect.
Thanks.
You can dance, by the way. I know this for a fact. I've danced with you.
I've danced with you, yeah.
Yeah. Jack, not really a dancer.
He's
fun.
He can let loose. You
yeah.
Know? He's
Is
out
he
there.
Intimidated by your dance moves?
I don't think he's intimidated by my dance moves, you know.
No.
Per se.
No.
But you know, he's a shoulder dancer. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. I would put him in that category. Yeah, he's like
he's in here.
Yeah, he's like cool, and you're doing yeah, flowing around. Yeah.
Yeah.
But now now can we cut to you're living in New Jersey, and you have a house, and you have also a. You have a horse.
I do. Yes, Jimmy.
This is a big deal.
I know. I got a horse. Yeah.
Are you into horses? I mean,
yeah,
you have
I'm
to be.
Yeah, I'm into horses. Yeah.
You have to be.
I think. Yeah. I'm super into horses. I was on a horse before I could walk. You know.
Really?
Yeah. I was born in Montana, and that's real
that's
horse.
That's real horse country.
And then moved to North Carolina, and I rode horses there too. My mom had a horse.
All right.
And then I would like go off to like Yadkinville, South Carolina with. Some guy named Shane and stay at his house and eat barbecue and do Western
guy
pleasure.
Named Shane. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He has some amazing stories.
Shane does.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway.
I almost bought a piece of a racehorse once.
What happened there?
I was leaving my apartment and this guy was like, Jimmy, do you want to invest in a racehorse? I go, yeah. So I called my business manager. I go, I think I'm going to buy a racehorse. And he goes, no. This is a disaster. Do not do this. I go, yeah, well, I'm just going to do it. It's just a piece of this horse, and I think it's smart. He goes...
And did you just... You saw the horse. You were like, this is a winner?
I didn't see the horse. I didn't do anything. My business manager's like, this is a nightmare. He goes, you might as well just flush your money down the toilet. It's terrible.
Yeah.
I go, no, I'm doing it. And so I did it.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, I'm going to name this horse. Like, I'm going to go brush its hair.
Yeah.
And I'm going to look at it.
I love brushing the hair.
Right?
Yeah.
And I'm going to say, you are a sea warrior. And you are going to win the Kentucky Derby.
Yeah.
And we're going to do it together.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the guy's like, you can't name the horse. The horse already has a name. I go...
That's a thing with horses. Yeah, they have these names.
Yeah, they have names from their, like, sire and their... And so I go, what is the name of our horse? And he goes, it's a Poco Bueno.
Poco Bueno.
So I go, what does that mean? And he goes, it means a little bit good. I go, why don't we get... I swear to God. So I go... Who bought mucho bueno? That's
yeah,
right.
Yeah,
first question.
Yeah.
I would even sell it for bueno. But Poco Bueno was my horse, and I went to OTB with my friend, and I put money on Poco Bueno, and it didn't even make it out of the gate. That was the end of that.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what is the name of your horse?
His name's Big.
Oh,
yeah.
Grande.
His real name, his long name, his like fancy name, Grande. Grande.
Yeah.
He's How's it been in Mexico City? Sorry, it's just been on the mind.
Oh, that's very interesting.
No,
last time Jack was on the show, we kind of came up with a great song together. How are things in Mexico City?
I mean, all this Spanish was just getting me.
Yeah, I thought Jack, this is the next big song, and I haven't. Well, my lawyer hasn't heard from Jack, saying that he's made the song. I mean, he could do it with Taylor, he could do it with Lana.
Yeah.
Whoever
I think
he wants.
It's probably that they're all fighting over it.
They're fighting over my song, you think?
Yeah. You know.
Yeah, so they can't decide. He doesn't want to be...
Jack's a politician. He's got to make sure...
Yeah, he doesn't want to be rude.
Yeah.
Sorry, so that's why I haven't heard from Jack?
Yeah, but okay. My horse is named Big on the Details.
Big on the Details.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Is that the horse's name?
It is, yeah.
I love Big on the Details.
I can just call him Big.
Yeah. I want to meet this horse one day.
But don't worry, your hit single's coming soon.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that. How's New Jersey, by the way?
I love it so much.
It's so wild because you're not from New Jersey. And normally when you hear, I love New Jersey so much, it's people that are from New Jersey.
I don't understand what's not to love. You've got the beach, you've got farms, and you're just so close to the city.
Yeah. I'm laughing in my head because you, at one point...
You got suburbs.
At one point you told me, you go, Jimmy, you should move to our neighborhood in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
And then now you moved out, you're in the city. So,
our neighborhood in New
Jersey. What would have happened if I moved into your neighborhood in Brooklyn?
Well,
I would have to come with you to New Jersey.
New Jersey, yeah.
I'd be next to Big.
Yeah.
Me and the horse could share a room.
I don't think that's such a bad idea.
It's not bad. I'll do it. Let Big know I'm thinking about it. We have to talk about your movie, Drive Away Dolls. This is massive. This is Ethan Coen.
Yep.
I mean, come on. He's a genius director. I mean, when you get that call, he's done so many great movies. Fargo.
Yeah.
What else have they
no
done?
No Country for Old Men.
No Country for Old
Raising
Men.
Raising Arizona.
Raising Arizona.
The Big Lebowski.
Big Lebowski. Not a big deal. All these just giant movies. Do you get nervous and go like, wow, I'm nervous auditioning? Or do you just go at this point?
You do. Of course. Yeah. No, I get real nervous. I mean, well, first I auditioned for Marion, and I didn't get it. So I auditioned for Jamie.
Is that right?
I just kept trying, right?
You go, hey, remember me?
Yeah. What about this, though?
How about this? What about this,
all right,
though?
So that didn't work, but hold on.
This is going to be...
another outfit.
And voila, I have a new character, yeah. Yeah. And he's like, oh, they're perfect.
Take two, yeah.
And it's a giant cast. I know Matt Damon's in it, Pedro Pascal. I mean, it's...
Geraldine Viswanathan.
Yes.
Yeah. Belzine.
Coleman Domingo. It's just fantastic. Well, how do we set up what the movie's about?
All right. It's two girls on a road trip going south.
There you go.
Falling in love.
Yeah.
Lots of mayhem.
Yeah.
Stuff goes wrong and stuff goes right.
That's... Busy sets up a lot of movies. It's very good. I want to show her in a clip. Here's Margaret Qualley in Drive Away Dolls. Take a look at this.
Where do you want to go?
Tallahassee.
Tallahassee?
What's wrong with Tallahassee? It's very nice. There's Spanish moss and live oak.
Curly here.
Don't call me Curly.
And your name Curly?
My name is Curly. We just met. It's too familiar.
Have you ever been to Tallahassee?
No, I got good sense. Your car is a Dodge Aries.
Oh, okay. Is that a good car?
Not really.
You sell those shirts?
Yeah, come on, look at you. Margaret Qualley, everyone, Drive Away Dolls is in theaters February 23rd. Brittany Howard performs for us after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.